Hi, this is Roger Schlitter. This video is really about investment property and really kind of how to value it. So anyway, investment property, how a bank will look at really a small property. There's many reasons to buy an investment property. The main reason is to make money. When you start out, you may want to buy a house next door or a fourplex in your neighborhood. I'm thinking you don't have thousands of dollars to invest in that project. But you will need a down payment, and actually you'll probably need a pretty substantial down payment. You'll need at least 20% of the purchase price. And that's if you're gonna just buy it straight without any government assistance or anything like that. You will have to charge enough rent to pay for the mortgage, pay for some of the expenses, have a few dollars a month to save for future repairs or renovations to the property. There are complicated ways to look at these projects, but this video is really looking at a simple property rental and how the bank will look at it, or how you want the bank to look at your project. Remember to adjust these numbers for your area or your neighborhood. Let's imagine there's a small home down the street that's selling for $250,000. You'll have to put down 20% down. That's a payment of $50,000. The bank will really want you to have cash, but if you borrow it from a friend or relative or get an advance on several of your credit cards, or you know, have the seller take back a note on 10 or 20%, some bankers will let you get pretty creative. But remember, banks are relatively conservative. So if you get creative, most bankers will really want you to have 20% to put down. And if you show the cash on your personal financial statement, you'll have it in an account. They will probably not ask where it came from. Some banks are okay with that because they just want the loan. A lot of bankers, they just really want the loan. And there will be a few that will really want you to be able to come up with a few thousand dollars just in case there's a repair in the first year that you'll have to pay for. But I think something like that you could handle. You know, you could put it on a credit card or something. So anyway, let's say the banker's willing to give you a loan for $200,000 for 20 years at 6%. The mortgage is $1,433. So you'll have to rent the property out for at least, I would say, $2,000 to $2,200 a month. The rent will really depend on rents in your neighborhood. And then expenses. The rental will pay for electric, gas, water. But usually sewer, insurance, and property taxes are probably on you. Other expenses they may have are like lawn care, snow removal, pest control, and then vacancy. Now, vacancy is the one expense that you never think you'll have. Vacancy is an expense that you may never have if you really have, you know, your rent set at market, and you check out your renters as to their credit and ability to keep a job. Some things are very little, you have very little control over, especially over time. So no matter how you check things out, you still could run into problems. Now, we could argue over the expenses, the value of the property, and the vacancy factor, but these are not really the things you need to really understand. The things you need to understand is the process of how to figure out what your bottom line is and if this is a good investment. Profit and loss statement should be to my right, and to your right, I don't know, but anyway, it should be over here. And we're really using the numbers that we outlined already. It is on a monthly basis and a yearly basis. A banker will want to see 3 years, even though they may be the same. Some costs will go up, and sometimes you'll need to raise your rent depending on the market. Now, on this profit and loss statement, we'll go over it line by line. The bottom line on this investment is the expenses. You know, they have to be on the money and or below, and the vacancy is kept in check. When the property returns like a 5% return on your $50,000 investment, but then there's a principal that is earned every year and added back into additional equity. When you include the principal, then that is an additional like 10.4%, giving you like a 15.4% return in this example. Now, when you look at this example, you know, to my left, you're going to see, you know, your commercial income property. You've got monthly and yearly rent, and your monthly times 12 should equal your yearly, I hope. And then your expenses, debt service, you can't do too much about, and that's what you're going to have to pay. Insurance, you know, property tax, and then sewer. Now, some of the things that you can do yourself is the lawn care, the snow removal, pest control. So there's a lot of these expenses that you could really do yourself. And there can be other expenses that you can save, you know, some sort of repairs that you can do, you know, if you're handy. And if not, just keep paying someone else. And then there's economies of scale. If you buy additional properties, the trick is, I've been told, is to make sure these properties are pretty close together, like within 5 to 10 miles. You don't want properties that take an hour to get to. And now there's more complicated ways to value your properties, but now there are more complicated ways to value properties. But if you already have one or two small properties, this analysis will work just fine. And the banker will believe and understand the analysis. You know, really we're looking at, when we look at this over here, we're looking at the profit and loss statement. And then we're looking down, and a lot of these costs, you know, you can, you know, we came up with total expenses of $1,793, you know, with gross rent of $2,090. You know, this is on a monthly basis. Did have a vacancy factor of 5%, which is pretty low. A lot of these times you don't figure on a vacancy. You figure most of these people are going to give you, you're hoping that they're upstanding and they'll give you, you know, a few months notice before they move out. Hopefully they don't do it in the middle of the night. That's usually when you miss a month or two. So anyway, the total expenses come out to $1,793. And we have a net income of $297. And then we've got repair. We've got $100 in there a month just for repairs, just for little things. And so the final net income would be $197, which really isn't a lot. I mean, $197 ain't much, but that's just for 1 month. So when you're talking the yearly, we're really talking, you know, a final net income of like $2,364, which really, again, isn't a whole lot. But it is enough to put a few more bucks into the project if you have to, if something comes up. We had on this, we had a principal of $5,196. We have a total return of the 5%. That's the ongoing, and then the 10.4. But anyway, watch the video. See if it helps you out at all. And if you take away anything from this, I hope you do subscribe. But anyway, this is kind of the way you want to look at your first couple properties. And then after a while, you may get more complicated as things go on. But anyway, thank you very much. And my name is Roger Schlater. And I will see you in the next video.